best thing you saw after you looked at the tape? What's the worst thing you saw after looking at the tape?
I think the best thing that we saw is that we executed. We got a little bit better on third down. We were 1-for-1 in the red zone. We were efficient running the ball. The worst thing that I saw is that we were our own worst enemy. We got to take care of the bad snaps. We got to take care of the two penalties that we got. We do that, and we've got a chance. We really do. You know, our whole mindset this week is make simple better. And if we'll make simple better, we've got a chance this weekend. We have to do that.
You said something about the Wildcat offense, and maybe that wasn't the right offense for this year. You looked at to further that, or have you done it?
We'll see how it goes, you know. It'll always be in the game plan. You know, it just depends on how people are defending it, but it's always in the game plan.
You ever thought about
what about the South Carolina defense? What do you see when you see them on
camera? They're definitely better than they were last year. A lot of those guys were young, and he's done a great job of getting those guys doing the right things at the right time. He mixes things up. He's never going to make you feel comfortable. So, you know, it's a huge challenge for us. And, you know, it's the SEC. It's on the road. So it doesn't get any better now. But they got a really good defense, and we're going to have to do a great job of protecting the football. And first downs are going to be tough, and we've got to make sure our defense stays off the field. And they do a great job in the red zone. We've got to make sure we get 7 points when we get down there.
In two games, what have you thought about Landon Young's play?
Landon has done a good job. He has he works on what we ask him to work on every day. He's very coachable. You know, he's working on, you know, everything with the offensive lineman is pad level in the run game, and you have to have great technique when you get speed rushers like we're going to get this week. You know, the guys off the edge, you got to be right, especially when it's loud.
You mentioned the guys coming off the edge. Mark alluded to a few missed blitz pickups by the young running backs. How do you get them to pick it up?
Well, they picked it up, but they just got the technique wasn't very good. You got knocked back into the quarterback, and that's all technique, getting a better base, anticipating. The good part about that is we were on the right guys. We just didn't do a very good job at executing and finishing. We got to be able to finish.
AJ only got 4 snaps. How does he get more?
Continue to do what he's supposed to do every single day at practice, and where I can trust him. And he had 2 great practices in a row.
Yeah, how do you feel like Saeed was coming along?
He had a really good game. His best technique grade that he's had since he's been here. He's running tough, hard nosed, you know, you can see he can make you miss in space. And I think that's. To him, that's what he brings to the table. You know, he had a couple of blitz pickups and did a great job. Ended up on the right guy and ended up blocking him, and so that was encouraging also.
Eddie, do you have to lean on older guys in an environment like this weekend, or can you go with some freshmen who maybe haven't been involved?
Well, I think you do. You know, you got some freshmen that are going to be out there, and it's going to be totally different than it was at Southern Miss. And it's going to be loud. It's going to be, you know, it kind of reminds me last night when I got home and I watched the Broncos, you know, the first play of the game, you know, the Chargers are getting a penalty because of the time running out. They're not communicating. They're not, you know, up there fast going. And you know, that's what we got to stay away from. We just got to just weather the storm, match their intensity. And at the end of the day, it's another game, and we got to make sure that we do what we're supposed to do and be disciplined.
How nice was it to see Blake step up this last weekend and really perform?
It was really good. You know, Coach talked a little bit about consistency from those guys, and that's kind of what we've been doing. And I think that Blake, you know, he made a couple great catches I alluded to last week. That I think after the game, that in practice he made a couple big time catches, and that carried over from the game, and that's what has to happen.
Eddie, obviously you all wanted to get him more involved, but is there some benefit to nobody else seeing what Lynn Bowden can do yet either as you get into SEC play here?
Yeah, I mean, you know, he's got stuff that he was in the game. He ran a great route when he had that penalty, you know, and he's going to have opportunities to catch the football in the game. So, you know, you look at K1 Ross and you look at Blake Bone, they both had about 40 snaps each. And it just, you know, when the time came, it came to Blake. You know, when K1's in there, he's got to make the play. When Lynn's in there, some of the other guys, he's going to it'll be fun to see him in that environment and get some opportunities. Hopefully we get the ball in his hands.
Hey, how's the bowling practice?
This week so far, it's been really good, you know. Obviously, you have different wrinkles each week, and so Tuesdays are a little bit rough on young guys because you do add new stuff, and then tomorrow will be another day for him because we add new stuff in third down and red zone. So, you know, he's got to get in the film room. He's got to study it. And guys out there, you know, you win the game on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and that's what we keep preaching. So Saturday will be easy.
These kids know how much they have to study.
Yeah, you know, because of the 20-hour rule, you know, we're always talking about we kind of had to have not necessarily a class, but really teach them how to, when you come in on your own, how to watch film and what you're really looking for. And so they have to take it upon themselves with huddle and so forth. They can get it on their iPads and they go home and they're able to watch it and study their opponent, especially personnel. You know, running backs, you know, they go back and they study the linebackers and how they're blitzing. Are they bull rushers? Are they a guy that makes a move? Are they a pull guy, you know? And so, you know, that's what they're having to do, especially when you're limited.
Coach, you talked about how it's going to be loud. It's going to be an intense environment, especially for those young guys. Is there anything extra you're doing, you know, like pumping music in or anything like that, to kind of prepare them for what they're going to see on Saturday?
Absolutely. We'll have a couple of days of loud noise and get it to where they can't hear. And now they've got to communicate like that. And we'll have a 25-second clock. Make it tell me 40-second clock, just like the game. And we'll try to make it as loud as we can. Usually we can't hear, we can't talk, and that's a good thing. So we'll try to make it as real as possible.
Do you have a similar strategy with Steven and Drew going into this game we had last week? Are you going to switch it up with them?
I can't tell you. That's a good question.
Gotta ask it.
Eddie asked a lot about discipline yesterday and how that's the biggest thing he saw from last week that needs to change. A lot of people think that there's some of the biggest change from week two to week three. What are you looking for in regards to change for your guys?
Clean football. You know, we talked about this week make simple better. And what does that mean? Well, when you snap the ball to the quarterback, it's perfect. And the snap count is a certain snap count. You stay outside. We don't hold. We use our technique. And so it just really comes down to making simple better. And we'll do that, and we'll have a chance. You know, you can't go on the road and you can't have turnovers. You can't have, you know, people that are jumping off sides in your first and 15. We did that twice on opening drives, and you just can't do that. You can't afford it.
Here we go.